the slogan that I used, nothing about us without us, which is something that a lot of people relate to, and it has a lot of history. Based on that, I came up with five different points that are relevant in disability movement, and also in many different other movements that I have learned from a lot of people who come from different intersections, whether it is queer, trans, Dalit, Adivasi, Black activists. And so one of the things that is very relevant in the disability movement is the interdependence with each other, ki hum ek dusre par nirbhar hain. इससे पहले हमें बोला जाता था कि इंडिपेंडेंस एक इंडिपेंडेंस मूवमेंट होता था, जिसमें जिसमें हम ये ऐसा बोलते थे कि हम अपने आप अपने लिए जी सकते हैं, वी कैन लिव द वे वी वांट टू, एंड वी हैव दैट केपेबिलिटी इन आवर बॉडीज, इन आवर माइंड्स. एंड एंड बट दैट मूव्ड ऑन टू द फैक्ट दैट दैट वी आर इंटरडिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर, दैट वी डिपेंड ऑन ईच अदर, दैट वी टेक केयर ऑफ ईच अदर. And that is very important for our movement, and that is how we thrive and survive together, that is a very important thing that I have learned, that it's not just individual, it's all of us that do all of these this work. All of the care work, अपने एक दूसरे के लिए केयर करना, एक दूसरे के लिए बहुत प्यार से रहना, ये सब चीजें एक इंडिविजुअल नहीं कर सकता है, हम सब साथ में करते हैं. दूसरी चीज जो मैंने बहुत सीखी है वो है सेल्फ डिटर्मिनेशन, विच इज ऑल्सो अनदर थिंग दैट इज वेरी मच intersectional to different movements, especially the trans movement that I have learned. In the topic of disability, self-determination means a freedom from the medical models of disability. So medical models of disability, also charity models of disability. So medical model of disability is disability being defined by doctors, by professionals, by psychiatrists, and they are the ones who give us a diagnosis about our bodies, about our minds. And that is the medical model of disability, where constantly the focus is on that something needs to be fixed within that person. So what I have learned that we need freedom from the medical model of disability, because we can self-determine what our bodies are, what our minds are. And it's the same with the charity model. The charity model also is something that comes from oppressive religious sentiments, dominant religious sentiments about how we have inherited a karma or bad karma, bad something that we did in our past, and now we are suffering for it through our disability. So self-determination is a freedom, gives us freedom to choose what we call ourselves, and what we how we determine ourselves. So this is also very much relevant in currently, because of the government we have. There is a constant kind of endeavor of defining what disability is, and we see that the current government is trying to define us by the word Divyang, which originates. Divyang is a word that originates from the charity model of disability, And in English, it is literally translated as the divine body, which means that there is some kind of divination that we have in the bodies that are disabled. So you will not hear a lot of about the history of disability rights movement that we have in South Asia, in India. Our histories are often erased, and because of these kinds of language and words that the government prescribes to us and the society prescribes to us, because we are not involved in a lot of the policy making. So most times we are still stuck in the definitions and terminology, where a lot of people say that humko disabled mat bulaiye, humko aap disabled nahi hai. Like a lot of people say to me, aap disabled kahan hai, aap to humko disabled nahi lagte. So these are things that erase our history and our collective understanding of collectivization of who we are and how we can be together. It's also the society's attitudes that create a barrier for us. And that is why it's very important that we read the history of our disability movements, and also credit the people that we have learned it from, a lot of people who come from different intersectionalities, who have done a lot of intersectional work. Then the third point that I would again bring up is about intersectionality again, because it's very important. It was a term that was coined by a Black feminist author. Her name was Kimberly Crenshaw, and she talked about how it is important to understand the different forms of oppression that we face because of our identities. So it can be ableism and racism, or it can be transphobia, and savarna casteism. So all of these different things, they come together and form the intersectional identities that we, the intersectional struggle that we all have, not identity, but struggle that we all have together. Then the fourth point that I would like to bring up is deinstitutionalization. So a lot of times in the disability movement, a lot of हमारे जो काफी सारे साथी हैं जो डिसेबल्ड हैं, जो द पीपल हु आर सिक एंड डिसेबल्ड, हु हैव क्रॉनिक इलनेस, क्रॉनिक डिजीजेस, आर स्टक इन इंस्टीट्यूशंस, whether it is mental institution or it is medical institutions or institutions of families. These are all private spaces that a lot of disabled people are trapped and imprisoned in, and that is something that that we have to really work for together, because if even one of us is not free, if one of us is not liberated, then none of us are liberated. And for this reason I work in art, because I want to step away from what therapists and psychologists and psychiatrists, doctors define as disability, because they are the ones who are institutionalizing us, who are imprisoning us and our communities, and there is so much fear that a lot of disabled people have for being judged for a certain way in therapy or for being non-productive, and so that's why I believe in like community based therapies through art, painting, craft, and spiritual healing, dance, music, support groups, all of these things that lead to collective liberation. Then I think fifth point that I would like to bring up is accessibility. Accessibility is also a big criteria that a lot of disabled people are advocating for. इसका मतलब ये है कि वी हम लोगों का तरीका बात करने का टू कम्युनिकेट टू वर्क इज़ वेरी डिफरेंट. वी हैव डिफरेंट आइडियाज ऑफ टाइम. सो देर इज दिस टर्म कॉल्ड क्रिप टाइम. क्रिप इज अनदर टर्म दैट इज यूज इन द डिसेबिलिटी कम्युनिटी एंड इट इज समथिंग दैट इज कमिंग अप नाउ. सो क्रिप टाइम इज समथिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो डिफाइंड बाय हाउ वी हैव अ डिफरेंट आइडिया of what it means in the normative heteronormative ideas of time, which means that you get an you are born, you get an education, then you get married, you have children. This is very heteronormative idea of time and progression of time, and for that reason crip time means that we define our own time. We cannot stick to the deadlines that are being given to us by the ableist and heteronormative society. And I think even in queer time there is a term called queer time that a lot of trans folks use that is very similar, where the time is experienced differently, where a lot of times when you either when you become disabled or when you transition, you you experience time differently. It's almost like that you are born again and you have to relearn all of these different things. And I think it's true for many different things that especially for me as someone who is upper caste, I am relearning, I'm unlearning the caste privileges and the class issues that are there in India right now. And all of this, I think my last point is that all of this comes together with a term called disability justice. That is something that is a culmination of all of these things that I described, and it is a term coined by Black, Brown, queer, and trans members of the original Disability Justice Collective, which was founded in 2005, and there are 10 issues that it talks about that can be found on sinsinvalid.org, and I'll type the link on the chat. So disability justice is what we are fighting for. It includes economic rights, state rights, and housing rights. These are things that we are fighting for primarily, so that we all have the economic and housing and state rights, so that we can all advocate for each other.